அன்புமணி ராமதாஸ்.
தேங்க் யூ சார் ஃபார் லெட்டிங் மீ ஸ்பீக் ஆன் த இந்தியன் மெடிக்கல் கவுன்சில் அமெண்ட்மெண்ட் பில் 2016 அண்ட் தி இந்தியன் டென்டல் கவுன்சில் அமெண்ட்மெண்ட் பில் 2016. சார், ஐ ஃபீல் தட் த நீட் என்ட்ரன்ஸ் எக்ஸாம் இஸ் அகேன்ஸ்ட் சோஷியல் ஜஸ்டிஸ், சோஷியல் இக்விட்டி, against rural students, against states' autonomy, against vernacular issues, language issues, as well as the minority institutions. I mostly speak for the government colleges, and I believe that this amendment is only for 1 year, this year. From next year onwards, both the government and the private medical colleges will fall under the NEET category. So coming back to NEET, there are some issues which the Honorable Minister has to address urgently and immediately. Tamil Nadu, for example, Tamil Nadu had an entrance exam from 1984 to 2006. In 2006, all the parties got together and said that we don't need an entrance exam. And then we had an act in Tamil Nadu which said that do away with entrance exam. When there was entrance exam in Tamil Nadu, about 15% of the rural students got admission for MBBS in medicine. Once we did away with entrance exam in Tamil Nadu in 2006, since then, 65% of the students who got admissions to MBBS were from the rural areas. So this NEET is definitely against the social equity and against the rural students. For an entrance exam, the students need coaching centers, and coaching centers are all in the urban areas. And to get into a coaching center, the student has to pay 5 lakh to 7 lakh rupees. And a rural student definitely can't have such money to do it. So this is definitely gross injustice to the rural students, and definitely the government has to oppose tooth and nail for the government colleges, even for next year onwards as well. Like, so this is something which is a very, very contentious issue on that. So we definitely need a lot more doctors, a lot more institutions have to come up, like, and the quality has to be regulated. Yes, there are issues about private colleges charging exorbitant fees or capitation fees. Some colleges charge even 1 crore for an MBBS. Some charge even 3 crores, 4 crores for a postgraduate. But then all the issues about government colleges, like a state of Tamil Nadu, a state's autonomy is usurped in here. The state of Tamil Nadu does a lot of investment into the health sector, and then again having an All India entrance exam. So one main issue is, like, why do we need an entrance exam? The student for 1 whole year slogs it out for the 12th board exam. Night and day he slogs it out, including his parents. And then after 1 whole year of slogging it out, writes an exam. Is that not needed? I mean, it is not enough. Why do you need 1 more exam? Why do you torture the students with 1 more exam? Why can't you have marks based on the exam for the 12th board? So, and also the disparity of the syllabus. We have huge disparities in our country about the syllabuses. And in Tamil Nadu, we have ICSE board, CBSE, Oriental, Matriculation, Anglo-Indian, State Board, or the Uniform Syllabus Board. And comparing the Uniform Syllabus or State Board to a CBSE, you can't ever reach that board, that standard. And imagine a student studied with a Uniform Syllabus Board competing for the entrance exam as a state on a CBSE board. It is definitely not possible at all. So absolutely it is against natural justice, it's against social justice and social equity, and also the state's autonomy. In fact, most of the states are opposing this, and the government also have to go take up this with the Supreme Court and oppose this tooth and nail for the government colleges. Also an example about minority institutions. We have a college, CMC Vellore, Christian Medical College Vellore. And there they are doing wonderful service, human service to the society. And here they are also going to be, issues are going to be on that. Also there's reservation issues. In Tamil Nadu you have 69% reservation issues. So I'd like the minister to clarify. Maybe this year he will. So next year onwards, when the government institutions again will be coming under the NEET, we'll be having a huge, huge problem. And definitely, through you, I request the government to take into these contentious issues and bring out to do away with this NEET exam. To do away the NEET exam for, I'm talking for the government colleges, and not only for this year, for the subsequent years, so that parity is restored and then social justice is restored. Thank you, sir.
This is the most of the members, what they are feeling, this all, sense of the house is like that. What do you think it, what you are going to proceed? No, that is what, see, most of the members, like you, people are raising this issue. Minister, already he knows very well what the feeling of the house. Okay, right. Doctor?